Welcome to Random Vlogs. Thank you everyone for sticking with my channel to watch all the videos. Let's look at the lavish life of another famous celebrity in the world and let's look at how they have spent their money on properties. Enjoy the video, don't forget to like, subscribe if you haven't already and leave a comment with what you would like to see next below.
In 2019, it was reported that Vanessa Hudgens purchased a new home in LA's historic Los Feliz area for about $5 million. This vine-covered colonial estate was built in the early 1920s and has a Hollywood history of its own. Prior to this enchanted mansion, Vanessa lived in a stunning Mediterranean residence in Studio City, which she sold in 2019 for $3.15 million. And today, we're gonna check out the actress's home. Vanessa Hudgens is an actress and singer best known for her role as Gabriela Montez in Disney's High School Musical film series from 2006 to 2008, which brought her mainstream success. Considering how well the first film did, it led Vanessa to land a recording contract with Hollywood Records, releasing two albums in 2006 and 2008. At the time, the High School Musical days may be long behind her, but she's amassed an estimated net worth of about $16 million. In 2019, after already settling into her current crib, Vanessa sold her former home for $3.15 million, a definite cut from the $3.85 million she was hoping to get for it. Either way, the star purchased the home hot off her Disney success back in 2008, for $2.75 million. While Vanessa's former house looks like it belongs tucked away in the Mediterranean somewhere, it's actually situated in the Los Angeles entertainment area of Studio City. During her decades of ownership, Hudgens did make a few changes to the home, including repainting the exterior in a bright white and adding Moorish-style decoration and touches throughout, including Moroccan lamps. The three-story stately mansion boasted 5,200 square feet of space with 6 bedrooms and 6.5 baths. From the outside, Vanessa's former home was elegant already, with a fresh paint color, curved staircase, arch windows, and balcony. There was also plenty of lush greenery out front, such as towering trees, vines, and more. The small front porch and carved wooden door opened up to a double-height entryway with floating wrought iron staircase, setting the theme for the impressive rooms to come. The bright and airy living room had a mix of contemporary and traditional, with red armchairs framing tall glass doors, which opened to the lawn. There were rustic hardwood floors with a natural beige rug over top, adding warmth as well as a long white sofa flanked by antique table lamps. The formal sitting room shared a cozy, double-sided fireplace with the opulent formal dining room. From one perspective, you can see the luxury dining room through the detailed archway with intricate gold ironwork. One focal point here is definitely the glowing brass ceiling with Moroccan-inspired lamp, all of which is contrasted with a modern table and chairs. Vanessa's high-end kitchen was equally impressive and full of notable elements. Cabinets were decked out in a mix of white and jade green, while floors were made of unique burnt orange terracotta tiles, adding to the Mediterranean vibe of the home. To round out the kitchen, there were coffered ceilings, designer appliances, and a casual dining space with windows looking out to the San Fernando Valley. The attached family room boasted yet another fireplace with built-in media cabinets and full glass doors opening up to an outdoor dining terrace. Elsewhere in Vanessa's mansion, there was a black-walled home theater with a widescreen projection system. The ensuite guest rooms on the upper level were joined with Vanessa's former master suite. This sprawling space was divided by a thick wall featuring a welcoming fireplace set in tiles, with the sleeping quarters on one side and the sitting room on the other. The windowed sitting area looked perfect to use as a reading nook with amazing city views, while other master retreat features included a luxury ensuite, walk-in closet, and private balcony. Finally, moving outdoors, Vanessa's backyard was built for entertainment and enjoyment. There was an irregularly shaped swimming pool and spa built in a lagoon style, also boasting a waterfall, as well as surrounding lounge chairs to sunbathe. Multi-level terraces round out the yard and were decorated with string lights, lush plants, and plenty of shaded areas. While her Studio City estate was no doubt beautiful, in 2018, Vanessa moved to the historic and trendy Los Angeles neighborhood of Los Feliz, snagging her current home off of actor Gary Oldman for about $5 million. Built in the early 1920s, the vine-covered colonial abode has quite the Hollywood history. It was built by director Cecil B. DeMille to house his alleged mistress, silent film star Julia Fay. During Gary Oldman's more recent ownership, he installed 18th century wooden floors. The walled and gated corner mansion checked all of Vanessa's boxes. While showing off her home to Architectural Digest, she explained, "I wanted an old home. To me, there's something so romantic about that, a home with character and quirks. I love the old Hollywood elements, the Art Deco air vents, the chandelier over the staircase, the yard that feels like a park. I love the old Hollywood elements, the Art Deco air vents, the chandelier over the staircase, the yard that feels like a park." The property wasn't listed on the open market, but Vanessa did recently give a tour of the home in October 2021 and a records show. It spans 3,168 square feet of space with 3 beds and 4 baths throughout. The Georgian colonial also retained many of its original features, adding to the character and class of the place. Situated on half an acre of land, the estate boasts a separate one-bed, one-bath guest house on top of a two-car garage. Vanessa reportedly spent 5 years searching for this dream home before she found it. She admitted, "There were so many things about it that struck me. Walking through the gate and seeing this house covered in ivy, surrounded by olive trees, it was like I had been transported to France or Italy. It felt like such an escape." While Oldman made some changes to the home during the time he lived here, Vanessa went on to make some of her own. She even enlisted the help of her former High School Musical co-star and friend Ashley Tisdale to make interiors exactly how she wanted. That included getting new marble, painting the cabinets, and other little details in the kitchen. Her kitchen boasts stainless steel appliances and plenty of windows letting in natural light. Meanwhile, in the breakfast nook, eye-catching House of Hackney wallpaper meets a 1950s pendant light and a leather banquette custom-made for the space. Vanessa's living room is cozy with French doors leading outside as well as a fireplace, piano, and plush furnishings. Main floor living spaces open to the expansive terraces outside and have an easy indoor-outdoor flow. While Vanessa took on the kitchen redecorating herself, she hired interior designer Jake Arnold to remodel the master bedroom. Her room is quite simple with quilted coverings on her bed, but the attached bath is another story. Vanessa opted for a dark cave vibe in her master bathroom. It boasts moody, dark walls and a deep ceramic bathtub situated in a windowed nook, along with a separate shower stall and vanity. Moving outside, Vanessa also added her own thoughtful touches back here. There are plenty of expansive terraces surrounded by stunning gardens, to one of which the star added a long table to host al fresco dinners. She also has a small citrus grove, including 2 massive grapefruit trees and elsewhere an avocado tree. The serene retreat offers a pool and spa as well, and Vanessa says about the yard, "All the limestone tile, the plants, the foliage help make the grounds feel like something out of a European retreat." Finally, the guest house is where Vanessa and her friends end up hanging out some nights to watch movies, and it's been transformed into the ideal space to do so. Alright, so I think that wraps up our Vanessa Hudgens house tour. We not only saw her current French-style mansion in Los Feliz, which she's no doubt proud of, but we also checked out her former Studio City mansion. While her current historic dream home was redesigned perfectly, I actually liked both of the actress's properties. Out of the two, which would you prefer to live in? I think her latest home has slightly more character and history, so I'll say that that one is my fave, but it's definitely a difficult choice. Be sure to let me know your thoughts on Vanessa's homes down in the comments.
Thank you for watching the full video and stay tuned for more. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment and share. Most importantly, stay safe.